This is our producer, Oliver, who hasn't been here for the shoot really at all. Just waltzes in whenever he wants to. Yeah, because he...
I'm not sure we've got EPK in the budget for this film. Have you spoken to me about this?
My character's name is Michael, and he is has had a broken relationship 6 months ago, and he is mourning the loss of that relationship, and he decides to ring an agency which provides a girl to take the place of his ex-girlfriend so that he can work through a number of issues.
I'm Melanie, from the agency.
I ordered a redhead.
Yeah, no way, I've got everything that you requested. I've got a wig, contact lenses, the lot.
It seems like quite an intense character to play. What's it like? Because I sometimes see you there, you know, going through your dialogue. And it seems quite intense, the thought process behind the delivery.
Well, I guess that, me doing that, is because I like to... I like to kind of skim over the lines a lot before I come on the day, and then just before shoot, try and lock them in so that they're as fresh as possible. He is a fairly intense character because he's going through a fairly intense time. So he's going through a whole range of different emotions, and because, you know, he's in a very awkward situation because he's actually hired this girl from an agency to kind of come over and be in his house and provide this service for him, which is kind of a fantasy, really, even, albeit a kind of sad one. So yeah, there's an intensity in that area, I guess.
There's been a few coincidences with this shoot, which is makes me believe that we're in good stead. Is that right, Matilda? We were at one point or another had a location up on Whale Beach, and we walked into this house, and this was on the wall, and it was.
So you stole it.
So we stole it from the house. We took it with us. So not only was there that Cockatoo reference, we also then came in here to the house where we're currently at in Randwick. And then Sarah, my fiance, is the production manager. She had a Cockatoo feather. And so we came in this morning and there's that Cockatoo feather already in the bars, and she thought that I'd put the Cockatoo in there, but the guys that I, you know, that live here,
They already had it,
so... Yeah, there's just been little chance encounters like that, which, I don't know, it's reassuring to know. It means that we should be making this.
The redhead is an English woman who's living in Australia, and she's the ex-girlfriend of Michael, who's the lead character in the film. You know, from Michael's point of view, she's not a very nice person. yeah.
How do you feel about being cast as someone that's not a very nice person?
It's quite fun. It's quite funny, I think. I think it's quite a funny character. And it's nice. It's funny, I've kind of got big eyes and big face, and I often play kind of warm, you know, characters. So it's nice to play someone who's a little bit sour and a little bit unpleasant. Yeah. I became involved in this project. I met Matt on a shoot for a Get Up ad about the carbon tax. Matt was playing a fabulous office worker, and we got chatting, and he got in contact with me afterwards and said he had this script, and he had Matilda and Alan on board, and they were looking for someone to play the redhead. Well, yeah, it was a blonde at the time, but they changed it to redhead. And I read the script, I really liked it, met with him, and, you know, here I am.
Yeah, I think it's more on the snarl kind of side of things.
She's got attitude, she's not right for you.
Yeah. But also I think it's more, let's talk more of a defensive thing. Because you feel threatened by her, because she's almost taking your place. She's got your hair, she's got your eyes. So she's got attitude. She's not right for you. But there's a little bit more defensive by that. That's
sure.
More of an attack.
Sure. She reminds me of someone.
Really?
She's got attitude. She's not right for you. The standoff. it's, as Matt described it, it's a battle of the body language. So I come in to see my ex-boyfriend and there's this woman here. It's quite a beautiful woman, but she's in a red wig and she's a bit odd. And we basically have a little standoff where we, you know, use our body to kind of have a battle. You know, as women can be very competitive and, you know, judgmental. I think it's a moment where two women come together and look at each other up and down and all the very worst elements of my character anyway come out.
So you're doing the score for the film?
Yeah, yeah.
Cool,
yeah.
So I guess we're going to come over and check you out in the studio.
Yeah, hopefully. Let's do it like a snap, just jump to the studio. Okay, ready? Let's go to the studio. We'll okay, cut cool. on that.
Yeah, remember that position. Yeah. Hey, what has Matt kind of told you in terms of the feel of the, like, that he's after, or?
Matt's a big fan of John Bryan, who did like Eternal Sunshine and Spotless Mind, and what else did he do? Punch Drunk Love, I Heart Huckabees.
The Future.
It's pretty good. He's like a pop musician that's just write some good tunes, really. Great themes. Captures a lot of emotion. I don't know where we're going to go with this. I haven't really seen much of the film. I've just seen on the little HD monitor. Been looking at that, so it's hard to know what's going to work. Yeah.
Cool.
Might do an epic John Williams orchestral score. I was thinking kind of like the E.T. tune. Think it's going to work. Get some tears going.